stars glow for you. Go see the world, cause it's all so brand new. So close your eyes, cause your future's ready to shine. It's just a matter of time before we learn.
Girls, so today we are going to do the Pledge of Allegiance in sign language. Okay, guys, here we go. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the Republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. Let's sing!
Called Savior. Have you heard of his perfect love? Have you heard of the one in heaven? Have you heard how he gave his son? Cause I have found this love. I believe in the Son. Show me your way. Jesus, you are my best friend. And you will always be. And nothing will ever change that. Jesus, you are my best friend. In the one called Savior, I believe he's the risen one. I believe that I'll live forever. I believe that my King will come. Cause I have found this love. I believe in the Son. Show me your way.
Nothing will ever change that. Exodus, Leviticus, Numbers, Deuteronomy, Joshua, Judges, Ruth, 1st and 2nd Samuel, 1st and 2nd Kings, 1st and 2nd Chronicles, Ezra, Nehemiah, Esther, and Job, Psalms and Proverbs, Ecclesiastes, Song of Solomon, Isaiah, Jeremiah, Lamentations, Ezekiel, Daniel, and Hosea, Joel and Amos, Obadiah, Jonah, Micah, Nahum, Habakkuk, Zephaniah, Haggai, Zechariah, Malachi. It's a letter from God that sets everyone free, a gift for you, for me. Genesis, Exodus, Leviticus, Numbers, Deuteronomy, Joshua, Judges, Ruth, 1st and 2nd Samuel, 1st and 2nd Kings, 1st and 2nd Chronicles, Ezra, Nehemiah, Esther, and Job, Psalms and Proverbs, Ecclesiastes, Song of Solomon, Isaiah, Jeremiah, Lamentations, Ezekiel, Daniel, and Hosea, Joel and Amos, Obadiah, Jonah, Micah, Nahum, Habakkuk, Zephaniah, Haggai, Zechariah, Malachi. It's a letter from God that sets everyone free, a gift for you, for me. Of the Bible, the wonderful books of the Bible. These are the books of the Bible, the wonderful books of the Bible. It's a letter from God that sets everyone free, a gift for you, for me. These are the books of the Bible. These are the books of the Bible, the wonderful books of the Bible. Books of the Bible, the wonderful books of the Bible. These are the books of the Bible, the wonderful books of the Bible.
You guys did such a good job dancing, you may have a seat. So, we have learned all of the books in the Old Testament. Now, what I'm going to do for you guys is I'm going to make a video in like a couple days. And I'm going to make a video of me doing the motion with the Books of the Bible song in the background. So then you guys can listen to the song, you guys can practice the song whenever you guys want to. So stay tuned for that, okay? But what I wanna talk about today is I wanna talk about how God has a plan for your life. Did you guys know that God has a plan for your life? Way before you were born, but even before you were in your mom's belly, God had a plan for you. Did you know that? God knew when you were going to be born. He knew the day you were going to be born, and he even knew the time you were going to be born. Isn't that crazy? But God knew you were going to be born, and God knows you, and God has a plan for your life. When he created you, God made you for a purpose. He made you for a reason, so that you can help other people. Now, I don't know what the plan is. God may tell me what the plan is, but he hasn't told me what the plan is for everyone. But if you guys pray and ask God, he will start to show you the things you're good at. He'll show you the talents he's given you. And those are the things that will help guide and direct you to what you're supposed to do and who you're going to be when you grow up in your life. Now, there's a Bible verse and it says, "For I know the plans I have for you, declares the Lord. Plans to prosper you and not to harm you. Plans to give you a hope and a future." Jeremiah 29:11. And what that verse means is that God doesn't have plans in our life for things to go wrong, for things to go bad. But instead, God's going to prosper us. God's going to bless us. God's going to give us gifts. And God has a plan. You are here on this earth for a reason, to do something only you can do. I can't do it. Miss Aubrey can't do it. Miss Vicky can't do it. Mrs. Alcott can't do it. Mrs. Amy can't do it. And Mrs. Jansen can do it. And Mrs. Barrett can't even do it. It's something only you can do. And the world needs all of us, all of you guys, in order to carry out God's plan. Remember, we're here on this earth to tell other people about Jesus, to spread the good news, the Bible, the good news, and to lead a life following God, where we listen to what God says to our heart and when he speaks to our mind, and we live a life following him. So what I want you guys to remember today is that you are here for a reason. God made you just the way that you're supposed to be. And he didn't make any mistakes, because remember, God never makes a mistake, okay? He made you for a reason, and he has incredible, incredible plans for your life. How do you figure out what those plans are? You listen to him. You read his Bible. You pray, and you grow closer every single day to him. And as you continue to live a life for God, he will speak to your heart and he'll speak to your mind, and he'll help show you who you are created to be. I want everyone to fold their hands and close their eyes, and please repeat after me. Dear Jesus, help me to listen to you, to follow your ways, and to keep you in my heart forever and ever. Thank you for making me and having a plan for me. And everyone says, amen. I'll see you guys later. Bye.
Ready for your last week of school this school year? So the last time we did calendar was on Friday. So what is the first day of the week that we do calendar? It's Monday. You're right. So today is Monday. What day was yesterday? Yesterday was Sunday. And that means tomorrow will be Tuesday. Very good. Now remember, what do we do on Mondays? We do it in Spanish, right? So we say, hoy es lunes, ayer fue domingo, y mañana será martes. Can you guys help me sing it in Spanish? Are you ready? Hoy es lunes, ayer fue domingo. Ayer fue domingo, mañana será martes, mañana será martes. Hoy es lunes, domingo, lunes, martes, miércoles, jueves, viernes, sábado. Estos son los días de la semana. Muy bien. Over the weekend, Friday was the 5th. What comes after 5? 6 does, you're right. So we have our 6 that we put there. And then Sunday was the 7. And in Spanish, 7 is siete. What comes after siete? 8. Muy bien. And what month are we in? Junio. Very good. Así que decimos que hoy es lunes, el 8 de junio 2020. Good job. Let's sing our months in Spanish. Enero, febrero, marzo, abril, mayo, junio, julio, agosto, septiembre, octubre, noviembre, diciembre. Estos son los meses del año. Good job singing in Spanish, guys. All right, now it's time for you to check what the weather is like and think about what the weather was like over the weekend, or maybe what the weather was like last Monday. Is it the same weather as last Monday? Or did last Monday, was it hot? And maybe this Monday it's cold. Remember, you guys can compare the weather from today to weather from the weekend or weather from other Mondays and think about how it feels and what it looks like outside. If the sky is cloudy or if it's sunny, if it's rainy, if it's windy. Remember, you can look at the trees and that'll help you tell if it's windy out because the trees will be moving, right? So go outside and have fun seeing what the weather is like today. I'll see you tomorrow. Bye.
Okay, boys and girls, so today is the second to last day of school. Everyone say, this is so sad. School is gonna be over tomorrow. We just have one more day of school. Isn't that so sad? I'm really sad. I might need to get a Kleenex. I'm so sad. I'm so sad. Okay, but we're gonna do something that I think you guys will think is really cool. So there's something called bloopers. Can you guys say bloopers? Bloopers. So what bloopers are is when you're making a video, sometimes things don't always go as planned. Like sometimes you'll say the wrong word, or you'll start laughing, or the sound is turned off and you guys really didn't know what we were really saying because we just showed you the video without the words to it. So, while we've been making these videos for like the past weeks, okay, there's been some funny videos that we have taken. And we want to show you these funny videos that you guys haven't gotten to see yet because we screwed up. We made mistakes. So, we didn't want to put them in the videos, but we saved them. And so, today is the day we're going to see these funny videos called bloopers. So, we're going to show you all the funny videos we have made while making videos. So if you guys think they're funny, you guys can laugh because I think some of them are really, really funny. So watch these bloopers of us making videos. Come on, come on, come on, let me show you what it's all about. Guys, I have to tell you something. I ordered a hairbrush from Amazon because I have this hairbrush right here and it's not really working. So like when I brush my hair, like my hair just gets like really snarly and like it's not working. See?
Oh yeah, I do see. A lot of those little bristles are
but
coming off.
But you were just talking about Amazon and how I may not get my hairbrush.
Yeah.
So it could be in the warehouse.
Okay.
And if it's in the warehouse, then you're gonna get it.
Okay,
but if there's no hairbrushes, she's all spilled out.
We're gonna start over.
Hi, you guys. So, what you'll need is a rag, and you'll also need something called Windex or whatever window cleaner you guys have at your house. So, the first step is spraying the window. One more time. and fold it in half. Someone might be calling me. Obadiah, Jonah, Micah, Nahum, Habakkuk, Zephaniah, Haggai. Do you guys remember what comes next? Because I definitely forgot. Hello, everyone. It's time to read the next chapter in our book, Crazy Hair by Miss Aubrey. Sorry. Just gonna tighten it there. A little better.
Hi, everyone. Here I found the people who are working behind the scene in the dark room.
Yeah. Oh no, I didn't film it. Okay, just say hello, everybody. Ooh, let me make a stopwatch. They're fighting. Yes, and this is more like a fighting battle, like in the army. It's not like a battle internally. It's something that's actually happening. That doesn't make sense, you guys. Okay. Hello, boys and girls. It's Miss Aubrey here, and today I have something special to show you. Okay, so I have with me a teddy bear, and I have a little bunny. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to show you how you guys can do a preposition work at home. Okay, so what you're gonna need is some stuffed animals and a basket. Guys, it's just a stuffed animal. No, it's okay. Ariana, can you just go outside for a second? Hopefully Mrs. Barrett won't mind that I peeled a potato.
See your alligator snap. Goodbye, stars glow for you. Go see the world, 'cause it's all so brand new.